Hi everyone, today we will be talking about a very important constituent of web development, and that is Cascading Style Sheet, or CSS in short. Cascading Style Sheet is a simple mechanism for adding style like fonts, colors, spacing to the web documents. And this language describes how HTML elements are to be displayed on the screen. It saves a lot of work and it can control the layout of multiple web pages at once. There are three types of CSS. Inline Cascading Style Sheet, Internal or Embedded Cascading Style Sheet, External Cascading Style Sheet. Inline CSS contains the CSS property in the body section, that is, the style is specified within the HTML tag using the style attribute. You can assign CSS to specific HTML element by using style attribute with any CSS properties. In this example, you can see we have added the CSS property for the HTML, H1 and P element in the same line of code. In this particular case, the CSS property, that is color and its value blue and red, are applied to the HTML, H1 and P element. So an inline CSS is used to apply a unique style to a single HTML element. Next is internal CSS or embedded CSS. It is used to define a style for a single HTML page. This can be used when single HTML document must be styled uniquely. An internal CSS is defined in head section of HTML page within the style element. That is, the CSS is embedded within the HTML file. The following code sets the text color of all the H1 elements on that page to blue and text color of all P elements to red. In addition, the page will be displayed with a powder blue background color. Next is external style sheet. With an external style sheet, you can change the look of entire website by changing just one file. An external style sheet is used to define style for many HTML pages. To use external style sheet, add a link to the head section of each HTML page. The style sheet rules are contained in a separate file. The style is no longer part of the HTML page, but is entirely separate file stored on the server. The CSS files usually end with .css extension. The link tag is key to add the CSS reference to the HTML document. This tag has relation, that is rel attribute in short, specifies the relationship between the tag and href. Href stands for hypertext reference. The relation attribute defines the type of relationship, and href attribute describes the location of the other document. The external style sheet is written as a separate file and saved with .css extension. Here is what the style.css looks like. In this example, I have given only the CSS color property to define the text color to be used. Inline styles are written inside the style attribute of the respective tag. In this example, I used the color attribute to apply styles on paragraph tag and H1 tag. In embedded or internal style sheet, we put all the style declaration in head section of HTML document. To do this, we wrap our style declaration in between the opening and closing of style tag in the head section of HTML document. When we put all style declaration in separate file and save them with a .css extension, then it is called external style sheet or external CSS. To do this, we link the CSS file to the HTML document using link tag. And the link is written inside the head element of HTML document. And here is the output for the respective CSS codes. Let's head over to our practical exercise. First is inline. Go to NetBeans. In File. Select New Project. Select HTML5 application. Click Next. 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 And uncheck all those things. And finish. Right-click the application and create a new HTML file and name the file as inline. Copy the code and paste over here. As I said earlier, the inline style is applied directly to HTML element via style attribute as demonstrated here. In this example, I have used different font family and font size and color attribute to apply styles on the paragraph tags. Save the file and run the file separately. And here is the output for the respective code, as it shows the different font family with different font size and color as we have given in the style attribute. Next is embedded style sheet. Create a new HTML file and name the file as embed. Copy the code. Paste over here. Embedded styles are placed within the style element within the head section of the HTML document. And this specified style information should only apply to H1 element and similarly for H2, H3 and paragraph elements as shown here. Save the file, run the file separately and you can see the output for the corresponding code. Next is external style sheet. Right click the application, create a new HTML file, name the file as external, copy the code, paste over here. The external style sheet is basically a CSS file that contains a set of style rules. This external style sheet can then be referenced in HTML file using link element. Right click the application and create a CSS file and name the file as EX. Copy the code and paste over here. The CSS file have some properties like color, font family and font size to define the text color, to define the font to be used and text size to be used for the H1, H2 and H3 elements. With an external style sheet, you can change the look of the entire website by changing one file. Now save the file, run the file separately. And this is the output for external style sheet.
Thanks for watching.